Obviously, the medicine found me, and entered my life to help me remember, while balancing myself to Mother Nature, and balancing itself to the communities and the families. So my path got engaged by traveling and going to different. Visiting different cultures, different tribes around the world, Africa, Asia, South America, North America. So saying that, I got to ingest all those sacred plants, all sacred medicines. And it all taught me that it's all from within. So basically at this point, I've been called to follow and unify the tribes. That's my main concern. Unify the tribes around the world through the prophecy of the condor and the eagle. So.
And the prophecy of the condor and the eagle is merging the masculine and the feminine?
It's basically balancing the feminine and the masculine.
Because at the moment we've had too much of a dominant masculine.
Masculine, and there were certain times in history where the feminine was the dominant. So now we're coming to a term, and I don't need to see or read. I just look from within how I'm feeling and what are the shifts going on around me. And it's that. It's that masculine and feminine coming to an alignment, a oneness. So that's why with the help and the instruction of the sacred plants and the sacred medicines, they are the ones who will balance us, like they balance every day Mother Nature. So.
And you think the plant medicines have a big role within this shift?
Yes, they've always had the big role of the shift, and especially now, where men and women are fed up with this. With the system that is not stabilizing us, it's just attracting us to more diverse paradigms of nonsense. So now our culture has gained up an ability to remember what was the one thing that unified us. It was the plants, our fruits, our the food. We used to unify each other and eat as a family. So the same thing that we're doing now, eating as a family in a table, we're doing that as well in sacred ceremonies with sacred plants. And we unify the tribes, unify the families. So that's where all the intensity of these plants has been in the last 10 years has been a big thing going on. And bringing back people together to go back to their homes and spread this love. Mm-hmm. That the only medicine really is love. Love is the medicine, and the medicine, the sacred medicines, it just remind us, and it's a big reminder and a big way and a big shift to focus ourselves, our center in love, in compassion, being that divine medicine as well, that we need to recognize each other and unify. It's not a philosophy, it's not a theory, it's a reality, it's a fact. And that's what we're here for the facts. We're not here to learn about some diverse religion, some diverse relationship with God or nothing. It's just really to, it's all from within us and unify. And that is our main focus right now. From here to continue the masterpiece that Pachamama has delivered in my hands, and continue traveling around the world to bring healing and unifying the culture and the families and continue the spread of how to self-sustain, you know, not just emotionally, but physically too, and with the children, especially with the children. We're working a lot with the children to bring them to teach us, to remember how to teach us, because they're our teachers. And it's time to stop putting our kids in a corner and just telling them what to do.
It's time to live by our rules.
And making them live by our rules. And this is what the medicine is teaching us, how to listen to our children. They come from with all this pure information from our ancestor to teach us.
Because children come living without any conditionings or things that happen in their life. The children really just live love.
They live pure love, pure gratitude. They're just there, you know, waiting for you to come and share that love with them. And that's what we need to remember. And the plants are teaching us very delicately and very careful. And with all the respect of the plants and with all the guidance of the plants, which is my number one teacher, we can achieve that. We can achieve to bring our children that are the ones who are gonna be taking care of this beautiful earth, to take care of it in a balanced way, in an eco-friendly way.